Hello everyone, this is Gregory Kasimis from the Metro Deli in Scarsdale. The Metro Deli has been part of the Westchester community for over 10 years. We always use the freshest and highest quality ingredients for all our dishes and catering events. Our breakfast features bagels with freshly sliced Nova. Don't miss out our thick challah French toast. For lunch, grab a booth and enjoy one of our oversized salads or our freshly cut hot deli sandwiches. We're open 7 days a week, where the coffee is always hot and freshly brewed.
This is Sports Central with Joe D and John Franchini on WICR.
Lillard slithering and drives. Oh, what a shot! Lillard!
Lillard defended by G. Game 5 seconds. No pick being set. Lillard now dancing. A long three for the win. Got it! At the buzzer! He did it again! Damian Lillard with ice water in his veins drains a three-pointer. A career-high 8 three-pointer made. And the Blazers walk off the court a winner again in dramatic fashion.
He's a gamer. That's all I can say, man. He's a gamer.
Lillard takes it and dunks it. Just about to say, Portland needs Lillard to get a little more aggressive.
Batum's had a big second half. They go to Aldridge. He has it knocked away back to Lillard. This for overtime. Yes! Oh! Lillard double clutches and hits it.
This is, you're watching the superstar. He's being born right in front of our eyes.
Aldridge the steal. Up ahead. Lillard wants it himself and jams it.
You are watching the future, maybe one of the best point guards in this league.
And we're back for our final segment of the evening, NBA, and we got to start with Damian Lillard, who this weekend will be a very busy man compared to most NBA athletes, stars who, you know, will participate in a few events, but this guy is making history, and he will be participating in all five events.
Holy cow.
Rising Star Challenge, the Taco Bell Skills Challenge, Foot Locker 3-Point Contest, the Sprite Slam Dunk Contest, and last but not least, the big game, the NBA All-Star Game. Gotta give it to him that he's not taking the time off like most people and going out there and just wanting to compete, wanting to have some fun.
Yeah, I mean, good for him. I mean, Damian Lillard, he's definitely an up-and-coming point guard in the whole league. And I'm a big fan of his, personally. And I'm so glad he's having all the success. I think he's a terrific player and going to continue to be a terrific player on this Portland Trailblazer team who really came out of nowhere and is having all the success this year in the NBA and is one of the most formidable teams in the West. And he's bound to win something, right?
I think so. You know, I don't see him winning the dunk contest. I could see him stroking it from downtown.
I could see him winning the skills challenge.
Skills challenge, maybe even the three-point competition. He's got some competition. He'll be competing against some good ones, but
the skills challenge. I'm looking at the list right here. You got Lillard. You got Michael Carter-Williams, the Philadelphia 76ers. Goran Dragic of the Phoenix Suns. Victor Oladipo of the Magic. Trey Burke of the Jazz. DeMar DeRozan of the Raptors. Reggie Jackson of the Oklahoma City Thunder. And Giannis. Ready for this?
Let's hear it.
Here's the best shot. Antetokounmpo. I don't know.
I'm not even going to try. That's why I left that one up to you, John. Thank you very much for
problem.
That one.
Giannis Antetokounmpo.
All right. Something like that.
Something around that area.
Talented enough to still be there.
Right. Of the miserable Milwaukee Bucks. I think Damian Lillard takes that.
Hey, he may be taking more than one thing. But before we go any further, let's answer our Twitter question of the night from @Packerman468. Who is the best team in the NBA heading into the break?
I think it's the Oklahoma City Thunder. It was last night. I'm pretty sure when they beat the Portland Trailblazers the other night.
You know what? I'm going to have to agree with you there.
Kevin Durant's on another planet.
Kevin Durant is my MVP this season. Maybe the NBA. He's my pick for MVP.
As is mine.
he is, the whole team as a unit is playing so well together without Westbrook, which is really intriguing, because if I'm OKC, and I've said it before, I may answer the phone for a few trade calls if anyone's looking for Westbrook.
Really?
Absolutely. Why not?
Wow.
Why not? Here's the thing.
I don't know, Joe.
Here's
I don't know if I would trade that. That's he's a great player, Russell Westbrook.
He's a great player, yes, but it seems as if the team has been able to gel without him perfectly fine, and Kevin Durant is much more efficient when he's taking 30 shots compared to when Russell Wilson.
Absolutely.
Russell Westbrook.
Russell Wilson. Holy.
Russell Wilson. Seattle.
Seattle, he got drafted by the Rangers. Where's he going?
He's all over the place. But
Westbrook, I don't know. He's a great piece, and I think he, when in the playoffs, when Kevin Durant gets double teamed, which he inevitably will get double teamed, I think that Westbrook will take the pressure off of him.
I think he will, but at the same time, I'm not saying Reggie Jackson's anything close to Westbrook, but he showed that he could run that team, run the point, where you would consider maybe listening into some trade opportunities if you could acquire some type of a big man, because I think that's if they could acquire a solid big man, because Kendrick Perkins, to tell you the truth, is just a big body out there. He really doesn't help you that much on either end of the floor.
He's a big dog. He doesn't do anything.
Exactly. He doesn't help you on either floor. So if you could, you know, maybe convince the Sacramento Kings for a little DeMarcus Cousins action.
Wow.
Exactly. That's
you're asking for a lot there. I don't think the Kings do that.
Why not?
If you're the Kings, you want to pair Russell Westbrook with DeMarcus Cousins.
Wouldn't you do that?
I really don't think that gets the Kings anywhere.
The Kings aren't going anywhere either
way. I don't think they go anywhere with just Russell Westbrook.
I think in terms of for the Kings, it doesn't necessarily help you, but at the same time, it does help in a sense that you're getting rid of the headache that DeMarcus Cousins is.
To me, he's a big all-star snub. He's averaging 22 and 10 this year.
Of course, but it seems like him and the ownership in Sacramento aren't getting along as well as any coach that comes into that. and the fact that Sacramento's the last team in last place in the Western Conference. I know. Is everyone seeing John tonight? I mean, he's about to pass out.
Oh, it's hot.
I think they raised the heat in WICR tonight. Or they just knew we were on the air. We were bringing some great stuff to the to the action. And
it's just our insight. It's on fire.
On point, all together, on
fire. Mike DeMarcus just can't handle this.
That's why he had to leave. He knew we were coming on, so he had to leave. But before we say our goodbyes.
Oklahoma City's the best team in the NBA to me right now.
Yeah, Oklahoma City right now, heading into the break, are playing the most well-rounded.
And number two
is?
Indiana.
Indiana Pacers.
And Miami's number three.
You know what? The fact that Indiana has that big man advantage over Miami definitely helps. The thing is, though, we may be seeing a Miami team who's not even playing at their potential right now, which I don't think they are, and who come playoffs time
they usually
will explode.
They usually just put it on cruise control in the regular season and get into the playoffs. You're like, all right, now it's time to go.
And they could afford to.
You're right. They have to conserve Dwayne Wade.
They can afford to, yeah. And Dwayne Wade is a huge piece who has shown that he needs his rest out there, especially with his knee problems. But checking into the NBA right now, our New York Knicks are currently leading at the half 54-48 despite Jimmer Fredette's 15
points. That's right.
Points.
Jimmer Fredette.
Fredette, the BYU Cougar?
Where did he come from? I only know who Jimmer Fredette is, don't they? Or was he drafted already?
I think he was drafted. Yeah, he was drafted.
Yeah, right, because Iona never would have been up 25, right?
Yeah. But as for the Knicks, Carmelo Anthony, as usual, leading the way. Trade deadline fast approaching. Any signs of Melo leaving New York?
If they were smart, they would. We're on the outside. We don't know what's going on over there.
Everyone is on the outside when you're talking Knicks, I'll tell you that much.
Everybody's on the outside when you're talking James Dolan, because he's clueless. But anyway, you don't know what's going on as far as Carmelo's agent and James Dolan and all them, what they're talking about. So as far as what I'm saying right now, if they're not talking about a contract right now and they're far apart, the smart decision might be to trade him.
Exactly, and if, like you said, we don't know what's going on inside.
Don't pull a Jose Reyes and get nothing.
If there's any fear that you may lose Carmelo Anthony at the end of the season, you trade him as soon as you can.
Very, very true. But if Carmelo wants to come back, and his wife, Lala, said that she says her husband, who they share the bed together, Joe, they wake up in the morning and have their cereal, their Honey Nut Cheerios, according to Kevin Garnett. They talk. They're together. Said that he's coming back to New York. You sign him.
Oh, absolutely. But like we said,
because unlike you, I believe in Carmelo, Joe. I believe he can lead him. And he can help. With help, he can lead. I think with Rajon Rondo comes to the New York Knicks, the Knicks will be on top of the NBA world. I'm actually getting a little bit ahead of myself. I'm sorry.
Wishful thinking. At the same time, though,
I think I'm starting to see mirages, Joe. I'm in the desert right now.
Yeah, it is getting
I'm seeing a mirage of an NBA championship in Madison Square Garden for the Knicks.
We definitely need to get John Franchini off the air if that's the case, folks. But at the same time, like we've said, if there's any fear of Melo not coming back to New York, take the loss.
Bye-bye.
Send him away. Let's get some picks and let's rebuild. It's time to rebuild.
Stop training our picks.
Exactly. You can't rebuild if you don't have any picks in the draft.
When the Knicks trade picks, they trade their picks from 5 years ahead.
And it hasn't resulted in anything.
And all the time, when the Knicks trade their pick, it's the best draft available. Look at this draft coming up.
Astonishing. Awesome, all around.
Terrific. Good job, Knicks management. Great job.
Well, doesn't cease to surprise me there. But unfortunately, tonight we are out of time. Make sure you tune in next week. If you haven't already liked WICR's page on Facebook, please log on www.facebook.com/WICR Iona College Radio. Make sure you listen live on Live 365 and Ustream. Just search WICR. Thanks for all our listeners, and we will be back next week. Hopefully in a cooler atmosphere, and the snow doesn't keep us from coming in.
Right. We're going to get blasted with snow tomorrow and Friday, so take care and be careful out there.
Stay warm. Don't go out. Have fun. Enjoy the games. Enjoy All-Star Weekend, and we will be back next week, same time, same place.
Have a good weekend.
Celebrate the USFL's 25th anniversary with this fantastic collector's magazine for the holidays. The USFL, the rebel league that the NFL didn't respect but feared. This must-have features interviews with players and coaches like Bobby Hebert, Marv Levy, and much more. Hundreds of photos will take you back to the 80s when Donald Trump was just an emerging name in pop culture. Hall of Famers like Steve Young, Reggie White, and Jim Kelly all got their start in the USFL. Order your Silver Anniversary magazine at USFLonline.com.